Good morning, student. Today I start 6th standard biology chapter 6 life process part video 5, the 5th video. So last class we studied about the digestive system of human beings and some autotrophic plants, then how carbohydrate can be diffused and aerobic respiration, anaerobic respiration. So in this class we study respiration. What is respiration? How respiration takes place in human beings, some animals, some aquatic animals, etc. Okay, today we start respiration. So here see, terrestrial organism breathe oxygen in atmosphere. So terrestrial organism, terrestrial organism means the organism which live in land, like animals, dogs, lions, then tigers, birds, etc., and including human beings also. They breathe oxygen in atmosphere. How can they breathe? They take air from the oxygen, aka oxygen from the atmosphere which are surrounded by us. So in case of aquatic organism means the organism or the any things or organism or living beings which are lived on water, right? The aquatic organism breathe dissolved oxygen in water. So the aquatic organisms, how can they breathe dissolved oxygen? So where they get dissolved oxygen? The oxygen present in the atmosphere, they can absorb. They absorb some plants and which are dissolved in water. So if you take a cup of water, then it's like an oxygen, it's an O2. What happened? These oxygens are taken in here, then it can be dissolved in water, right? So these are dissolved oxygen take which organism? Aquatic organism. They can use as breathing process. So what happened in this case? In this case, the aquatic organism require more dissolved oxygen compared to terrestrial organism. Why? They contain only little amount of the oxygen which are dissolved in water. Example, if we breathe 20% of oxygen in atmosphere, but in the same time the aquatic organism breathe only just 10%, because they can dissolve only minimum amount in water, so they cannot be sufficient. So the aquatic organisms breathing faster, they breathe in faster. Right? So in human beings, how respiration is takes place? So we detailedly study how respiration is takes place in human beings. So in human beings, take an air in nostrils. What? Nostrils. This is the rough sketch. You clearly watch in your textbooks, they given. So clean watch in your, open your textbook and draw the diagram and watch this. So what is this diagram, respiration diagram? So there is a one nostril, nasal cavity. Then rings of cartilage. This is the rings of cartilage. Then this one is the bronchi. What is the bronchi? This one. This one is the bronchi. Then this is lungs. Whole system is the lungs. And you see in the dark rod like structure, right? Some here. This is ribs. Ribs. Then alveoli of sac. What is this alveoli of? Then lungs have a small balloon like structure. Feathers. This is like feathers. The feathers contain like balloon like structure. These alveoli lock, and this length is called as a bronchiole. Then in this diagram we can draw the diagram, so rough sketch this one. You have to observe your textbook. So this is the alveoli. So it is ball-like structure, right? Balloon-like structure. This is the alveoli. So this one is a bronchiole. So you have to observe in your textbook. So what happened? In human beings, they take an air. Which air? They breathe always oxygen or carbon dioxide. They breathe oxygen, right? So they take air and which through nostrils. These nostrils have a fine hair like structure. Have you observed some fine hair in your nose? So not that. So inside there is a lot of fine hair there. So these non-fine hair have helped to remove dust, then undesired air, some waste. Say they can clean up the air. They pass it only fine, simple, clean air, perfect air, which is oxygen, right? So air passes through nostrils, which are filtered by fine air. Filter means waste particle, dust particles are filtered through hair. Then the fine air moved to a throat. Where? Throat. So throat. What happened when these throat have a rings cartilage? Have you seen, right? This is the rings cartilage. This is the rings cartilage structure. Round, round, round. So like. So if what happened? These rings cartilage have do not collapse air passage. Do not collapse. Why? We take and breathe as a oxygen and exhale the carbon dioxide. So oxygen and carbon dioxide do not collapse. So which one helps to? Throat has a ring cord. These ring cartilage helps to be do not collapse the air. Right? Next, what happened? Then it moves to a which part? Then it moves to a lungs. With this is the lungs. So what happened is when lungs, when we breathe in, inhale the air, our ribs and lungs are expand, right? We take air, you have to do it, right? Do it one more. What happened? So inhale air, so our lungs and ribs are expand, this is large, and diaphragm became compressed, right? So when moved to lungs, they pass as a smaller tube is alveolar. What happened when air is passes to reaches to lungs? Up to this, they pass like a small tube structure. They divided as a smaller tube. The air passes several tubes which are small in size. So for these air, the smaller tube is called alveoli. So I have drawn, right? This is the alveoli, right? Alveoli. So if alveoli has a balloon-like structure which provides large surface area. So when inhale the oxygen, our lungs are expand, they get large. Due to the alveoli has a large surface area, they can expand. So it provides a large surface area for air when it reaches to the alveoli. What happened? The gas exchange will take place in alveoli. The gas exchange. How gas exchange takes place? They contain only two gases, oxygen and carbon dioxide. So we inhale oxygen, when it reaches to the alveoli, then gas exchange takes place. How? Alveoli walls contain blood vessel network. Have you known blood vessels? So in our body, there is a lot of blood vessels. So they contain the alveoli, this is alveoli, this is alveoli, they contact with blood vessels network. See, this is a blood vessel network. What happened? These blood vessel network is when contacted with alveoli, the oxygen is reaches to alveoli, they passes to oxygen to blood vessel, and the blood vessel pass whole oxygen to the throughout the tissue of cells. So throughout the body, oxygen, whole oxygen are passed throughout the body. Through how? Throughout the blood vessel network. So the blood brings carbon dioxide to alveoli. What happens similar time? The blood vessel collect all carbon dioxide in our body through nerves or some connections. the carbon dioxide which are present in body, they can collect the blood, they can collect which one blood vessel, and it transferred move pass to alveoli. Similar to alveoli gives a oxygen to blood vessel, right? So blood brings carbon dioxide to alveoli. The oxygen in the alveoli, alveolar air, oxygen in the alveolar air pass to blood vessel. So alveolar air, that means alveolar sac, right? This is the alveolar sac. The alveoli contains a the alveolar air. These oxygen contain alveolar, they pass the oxygen to blood vessel. Similar time the blood vessel pass the carbon dioxide which are located in our body to alveoli. So alveoli gives oxygen to blood vessels to pass transport to transport it to the cells. So oxygens are come from the lungs. What happened? So I will explain one more time. So in human beings, air can be passes through nostrils. They can filter by fine hair. Then they are passes to throat. When throat reach, they contain the Ring's cartilage. The Ring's cartilage helps to do not collapse the air passage. So collapse, they do not collapse the air passage. Then they move to where? Then they move to the lungs. They when reaches the lungs, they have divided as a small tubes, which this small tube is called as alveoli. You know, you have to observe in your bag. So when reaches to the alveoli, what happened? When reaches the alveoli, they can expand. When we inhale, our lungs expand because the alveoli has a large surface area. They can expand. Which one? Alveoli. So whole alveoli expand, the lungs is also expand, right? Become large when inhale. So that time we think about it, that our oxygen is reaches to the alveoli, right? When oxygen reaches to alveoli, the gas exchange takes place. The gas exchange, which one gas? Carbon dioxide and oxygen. How? When the alveoli walls has a blood vessel network, because the alveoli have a blood vessel network, walls, outer walls have a blood vessel network, they bring carbon dioxide from the cells of our body. So when blood vessels give carbon dioxide to alveoli, that similar time the alveoli passes the oxygen to alveolar air. The oxygen contained alveoli is alveolar air. This passes to blood vessel to transport the cell. So this is the easy and simple method. So what happened? Do you understand, right? You have already a doubt, you have to ask me. So what happened in another case? If your body size is large, when body size is large, diffusion pressures are occur. So pressure are occur. So that time the oxygen does not reach us to whole part of the body. Why? It takes time, right? When body reaches to alveoli, the oxygen reaches to alveoli, the oxygen passes through the whole cell through blood vessel, right? So when body size is large, they cannot reach particular each tissues of cell. Why? This take time. If they have more than tissues, how can they reach particular time? So it's not possible. That times the deficient of oxygen to tissue. So what happened? There is a deficiency of a oxygen. So the deficiency of oxygen on tissue. So what happened in human beings? The human beings have a hemoglobin in blood. So they have a hemoglobin. The hemoglobin contain iron content, right? So they have a, our blood is red. So this is basic. So why our blood is red? They contain hemoglobin, which have a iron content. The hemoglobin, which we are high affinity in, to an oxygen, they can easily high affinity. They can accept absorb the oxygen easily from the blood vessels. So in human beings, because they have a hemoglobin, they high affinity to take a oxygen. So in this class we study life process of the respiration. What terrestrial organism breathe oxygen from the atmosphere, and aquatic organism take a dissolved oxygen in water. Next, human beings, this process is very important. How respiration takes place in human beings, or how carbon dioxide and oxygen are transferred, exchange takes place in human beings. So you read must, they are given in textbook. So read once again and recall it. Then I will give notes in next class. Thank you.